So we're progressing quite nicely with the mix. We're up to about 16 minutes here. And we've played one, two, three, five tunes. So we're keeping them nice and short. It's a bit more in keeping with a kind of a poppy mix. Keep the tunes flowing. Quite happy so far with it. Over the next few tunes, I'm going to do a kind of a fast forward video so you can see how the rest of the mix progresses in quick time. Otherwise, we're going to be here for hours. I will stop towards the middle and have a chat, and we'll see where we're going with the mix. But up to now, things are going okay. They've progressed from just over 100 beats per minute up to 120 after about 15 or 16 minutes. I'm quite happy with that tempo. I'm going to stay with that for a bit. I'm not going to go too much higher. So we're in 10B, it's 120. I'm going to put one more tune in here, and then we're going to sort of fast forward a bit through the mix. So let's have a look what we've got. We are in 10B, so I've mapped out mixed in key and I've had a look down here. And I quite fancy this one here, so I'm gonna pull that one into mixed in key. This is quite a nice minimal kind of one, it's in the same key, similar tempo. This is about as deep as I'm gonna get in this pop mix, but I quite like this. It will sort of change the mood a bit. And let's see where we are. Oops, there we go. Let's import that. I've just dropped it in. There it is. Now, I'm quite concerned about mixing out of this track because it's really busy at the end. Let's have a look at our main arrangement points in this track. Here we can see something's going on. It looks like the breakdown comes around here. I'm just going to nudge this up to one of our main markers in Ableton just to keep things organized. I'm going to use 4-8-1 here. So I'm going to highlight everything. So Command A. I'm going to take this point here because I know that it's a main arrangement point in the track. And I'm just going to nudge it up one. There we go. So I know things are pretty regulated. As I said, this isn't essential, but it really helps to keep things organized. And then at the end of the mix, we can get rid of this time that we've lost. We can just get rid of that. So where are we? So back to where we were. I'm concerned that this is really busy. So I might have to use a similar technique as we did before. I've noticed that the intro of the record is the same as the outro in terms of the chord progressions. That might not always be the same. Sometimes the intro of a song has a slightly different kind of progression or movement in the chords, but this time they're the same. So we can actually break it back down into the introduction. If you just listen, there's loads going on. So it does drop into a beat and a bass line, and then everything falls out. So we've got the option, I guess, to extend that beat just with the bass line and kind of make more of a transition point out of it. My sort of preference would be to take the beat without the kick, the beat that's a bit more minimal at the front. And maybe we can even play around with this bit as a transition at the end. So let's copy over, alt drag, and we'll just see if it makes a nice out point. Okay, let's warp this one and we'll see how it's getting on. There we go, there's our kick, something to hang on to. So listen. So it's good to, while we're doing the warping, just try and identify points that might be good for transitions. I mean, this is great. It's just a little kind of garage beat at the end with a vocal. It's quite sparse. So that could, you know, we could loop that and at the end of the record as a nice mix out point. Right, let's see what we've got going on here. So we've warped everything up. Let's maybe start it at the beginning. Would be a good start. See, I'm not sure whether the record should start here or there. In that case, the best thing to do is to go back to your kick here, because I think that could be the beginning of a bar. And let's run that to the end and run it back that way. Then we know the kind of arrangement will be a bit more accurate. Yeah, that's gone a bit awry. Let's check it from the beginning. So the timing's quite nice. This track I'm mixing in has got a kind of a strange build up. It doesn't fit to any timing. So what I'd quite like to do is make sure that this isn't so abrupt. So remember we had the beginning kind of chord lead in here. Let's take that and stick that at the end. And we'll move that. Yeah, it was a bit nicer. I mean, it's not 100% ideal. I quite like it. I'll probably stick some delay on that so that sort of runs over just to ease this transition because it is quite short. We could loop it, I guess. Yeah, it's a bit better. We've got a slightly longer transition period because we looped it. And I think that kind of suits the style of tune that's coming in. It's quite a little bit melancholic and sparse. So I think that works quite well. So over the next few tunes, I'm going to go into fast forward so you can see what I'm doing on the screen. Otherwise, we're going to be here for hours. So I'll come back towards the middle of the mix, and we'll have a chat about what's gone on.